we'll start the conversation with Dominic. Kasi ang Philippine Development Plan po ng gobyerno, eh, sabi nila, the unemployment rate will decline from the current 5.5% to 3-5% in 2022. Pero in-assume nila na ang labor force participation rate is 64.1%. So that means that that situation implies that we will be increasing employment by 950,000 to 1.1 million employees, new jobs per year. Sinabi pa nila, I am quoting from the Philippine Development Plan, youth unemployment rate will decline to about 8% from the current 11%. In areas outside Metro Manila, NCR, the underemployment rate will reduce to 16 to 18%. Ngayon, ang question ko, Dominic, is ano ang nangyayari sa 1, labor force participation rate, and 2, have we generated 950,000 to 1.1 million jobs per year?
Sa ngayon po, batay po sa labor force survey po ng Philippine Statistics Authority, January 2019, ang atin pong labor force participation rate ay bumaba po mga nasa 1 to 2%. So, ang equivalent po niyan ay mga 2 million halos din po ang lumabas doon sa labor force. Karamihan po ng mga nakuha po na latest labor force survey, nag-introduce po tayo ng K-12. Uh-huh. So, marami po yung mga bumalik na kabataan sa pag-aaral po. And then, siguro mga around 800,000 po itong pinag-uusapan natin. And then, siguro mga 360,000 naman po or hanggang 500,000. Ang sinasabi po nila, kaya po sila umalis sa labor force ay dahil po sa pagkakasakit po nila. So, they cannot participate economically.
So, you're talking about 1.3 or 1.5 million of the 2 million reduction in labor force that went out because A, they wanted to continue schooling, and B, nagkasakit sila. What happened to the 500,000?
Meron po tayong tinatawag na discouraged workers. So, ibig sabihin po, parang sa tingin po nila, wala na pong pag-asa na sila po ay makabalik pa o makapasok pa po ng trabaho.
Well, marami hong mga puzzles na de-develop ngayon sa labor market, sa labor market analysis. Yun hong concept ng discouraged workers, increasingly naging popular ngayon sa discussion sa US labor kasi in recent years, pagkat yung maraming grupo ng mga manggagawa na hindi na alam nilang walang trabaho nag-iintay sa kanila, so they simply do not look for jobs. So they are called discouraged workers. Now, we also know na hindi porke nag-grow ang economy, natatranslate yan sa job creation. At malaking bagay po yun. Right now, ang job creator na nakikita natin, itong sa construction, construction left and right. Pero marami hong nagtatanong sa amin, hindi ba itong election ay dapat mag-create ng jobs? And then, and in addition to that, tataas ang mga bilihin, that inflationary. Pero nakita nila na parang hindi naman tumataas ang inflation ngayon, pero hindi rin dumarami yung walang substantial number increase in jobs.
President Duterte's Philippine Development Plan says that, I mean, its target is to increase employment by 950,000 to 1.1 million new jobs a year. So can you do that? Can your department do that?
Siguro lang ho alamin natin nasaan yung decline, anong sektor. Kung mapapansin niyo po, noong pong first year talaga ni President Duterte, first full year po niya in 2017, we lost about 660,000 or 680,000 jobs. Ito po, we attribute this to the policy of the ENDO. Talagang malakas po yung campaign noon. And we're happy to say naman na kahit na po sinabi natin na may nawalan ng ganung numero ng mga manggagawa, pero po, bumawi ho tayo doon sa quality ng employment because kung mapapansin nyo po, yung underemployment po natin, which is another big problem po, more than the unemployment problem ay napababa po natin kasi we go about 18% in underemployment, but we were able to get
it down to 15.
15 yung latest, but it went down to 17-16%. At mahigit 1 million din po yon. So, tingnan ho natin yung kalidad versus the quantity versus the quality. Then, the other factor, Ma'am Winnie, is yung nitong latest survey po ng labor force survey natin in January, 1.7 million po yung nawalang trabaho sa agriculture sector. So kahit na po lumago yung services mo at saka po yung industry, hindi po kayang kaya nag-negative pa rin yung suma total ng January 2019 eh. Kasi 1.7 yung nawala sa agriculture, pero ang services po at industry mga nasa around 1.3.
Industry and manufacturing could not absorb the labor that was going out of agriculture. That is, that is a challenge to development.
Totoo po yun, ma'am. Sabagat sa agriculture, almost all major crops are in crisis.
So is the labor department, the labor people, saying that the fault is with agriculture? The agriculture department hasn't been doing its job, increasing the productivity, increasing the employment. Is that what you're saying?
Well, I'm not blaming the.
I'm pushing you to the wall, huh? It's very important because most of our poor come from agriculture,
exactly.
And if you leave agriculture like that and just say we're concentrating on industry and manufacturing and all. And agriculture is being left behind.
May crisis din ho sa mga urban communities. And then itong mga, some of the build projects, bagamat we need the infras very badly.
So where is the growth of the Philippines going? It's not going to jobs, or it is going to better quality jobs, and the poor are left jobless. So what are the positive elements of the growth of the Philippine economy that will help the poor? Because it seems that the businesses are enjoying themselves, their profits are high, etc. But labor, your sector...
Meron pong isang bagong study. Ang Pilipinas nagde-develop ng bagong archipelago. Archipelago ng yung mga mayayamang areas. Archipelago within the archipelago. Islands of growth. Yung mga high-rise, may mga condominium, mga ganda ang facilities. Pero... what happened to the rest? Yun po ang gan.
In other words, it's a very unequal. It is not an inclusive growth, which is the target and objective of the Philippine Development Plan. So what are you doing about it? You're in labor, and you know that there is this problem. Do you think, for example, that increasing the minimum wage will help the problem?
I think more than increasing the minimum wage, we have to improve the productivity of our labor force. Kasi lalong-lalo na ho dun sa agriculture sector. Siguro ho, tingnan natin ano yung mga growth areas natin. So we have, as mentioned earlier, construction, then manufacturing, and then sa services sector po, we take advantage of the growth also in the wholesale and retail. Kasi ito naman po talaga yung pinakamalaking employment generating sector po natin, and the administrative support and information and communication. Una, we really have to retool and reskill our existing labor force, lalong-lalo na po yung mga unemployed at saka vulnerable. At for them to be able to take on the opportunity na nasa labor market po natin. But pangalawa po siguro, in terms of job creation, we need to do more. But job creation is a function of investment. So we have to look at what kind of investment are coming in at ito ba ay talagang nare-realize po natin.
In other words, is the quality of the investment that is coming in job creating. It's not the quantity of investment only, it's the quality.
Yes,
I'm glad you're
quality.
Saying that. Do you think increasing the minimum wage will help the situation or it will hamper the situation? What do you think, Rene?
Ang minimum wage issue po, matagal na ang debate dyan. At ang malaking problema po, iba-iba ang capacity ng industry.
Mm-hmm.
We start with the small and medium
small
enterprises.
And medium.
But those who are capable, ang suggestion ko po, dapat gamitin ng gobyerno yung county, may power ang ating gobyerno to push yung mga employers at saka labor maupo at mag-negotiate. Kulang ang culture of dialogue.
Tay muna.
But we have the tripartite.
You're saying, it, you know, the minimum wage should not be set nationally. Do you agree with that? There should not be a national minimum wage. Do you agree? Because that is the current policy of government. They said wages should be set regionally because of the different patterns or even by industry, which is what you want to happen.
Yeah, ang position ko po, ang minimum wage should be the way minimum decent wage for the unskilled and unorganized. Ang way forward, upgrade yung industry. And then pag nag-roll yung productivity, magkaroon naman ng sharing.
In other words, you say, remove the minimum wage.
No, I'm not saying. I'm not saying that.
We cannot remove the minimum wage kasi okay. Safety net yun, ma'am.
Are we agreed that a minimum wage should not be set nationally?
Depende ho sa industry minimum wage can be national.
No, but you know, but it's not national. It's not all over.
Hindi ho yung right. Yung parang one for all or all for one.
Hindi pwede yun. Do you think that the minimum wage should be used as to help poverty?
Pag malawak po unemployment, without the minimum wage, magdadive yan, race to the bottom.
Tay muna, hindi man sinasabing walang minimum wage, pero hindi pwedeng minimum wage na 750 or 1,000. You think that it should be 750? I just want a yes or no answer.
Sa tingin ko po, hindi pa siya nararapat ngayon.
Depende ho sa industry, pwede yung 750.
Kung hindi ho tayo magsisikap sa sarili po natin, kung hindi po natin palalakasin yung ating skills, kung hindi po tayo gagawa ng paraan para makakumpit po tayo sa larangan ng labor market, and then tayo rin po ang pwedeng magiging reason dun sa downfall po ng sarili natin.